gather here in the presence of God to joyfully witness and bless the marriage of Llandro Llander and Martina Otto, let us begin by joining together in prayer. O God, we thank you for your presence among us on this joyous occasion. In the quietness of these sacred moments, we remember that you planted the seeds of love in the human heart. Now, as Llandro and Martin stand before you and their family and friends, we affirm the love that has brought them together. And we ask especially that you would be with Llandro's family members who are unable to be physically present with us, but we know are here in spirit. Amen. You may be seated. Heart, body, and mind is a gift from God. It is a gift which is intended for your mutual joy and for help and comfort in one another in times of adversity and in times of prosperity. Marriage is therefore not to be entered into lightly, but reverently and deliberately, and with trust and true affection. Martin and Llandro, God has been with you met and rejoices in this day when your love and commitment to each other is officially confirmed here at the Riverside Church and affirmed by New York State. It is an honor to be with you today as you publicly proclaim your willingness to love, honor, and make this covenant of marriage with each other to live out the rest of your lives as a married couple. You share a love that has enabled you both to grow individually and as a couple. But your work is only beginning, because as you've already experienced in your lives together, relationships do take work. Complacency brings about laziness. Love takes work, and it takes time. And it blooms daily in our hearts, so although this may sound corny, saying I love you and meaning it at least once a day is so important, because love brings about more love, but love also brings about more strength. Committing your lives to each other involves an ongoing working relationship, a relationship that is supported by all of those who are here in this room and by God. But it is up to the two of you to continue to work toward the deep, abiding love that brings respect, honor, and honesty that enable you both to continue to grow individually as well as a couple. Deep abiding love needs the input and tender care that others bring into your lives, so be sure to continue to keep yourselves open to your friends. Because as witnesses to this ceremony, we all take an active part in helping you to sustain your partnership and your love. The journey that each person in this room has taken with the two of you stands as additional strength for you and love for you, and it's integral to your maintaining your love for each other. So allow your love to continue to grow and deepen with each and every passing year by including your friends and your family in your joys as well as in your sorrows. We are committed to supporting both of you and will pledge to do so later on in this ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, Martin and Llandro have asked that I share with you in their own words their reasons for recalling three different scriptures during this ceremony. They have come before this altar today because they love each other. In the lofty words of the famous Love chapter 13 of 1 Corinthians, St. Paul states that tongues, prophecies, knowledge, faith, and hope will someday pass away, but love will remain forever. Love is the essence of God, and like God, it cannot be limited. Theirs is a love that is not always understood, but even in the Old Testament, with its conservative worldview, there are two compelling stories of love that challenge the norm. First, the love between David and Jonathan was extraordinary and all the more telling because it is in the scriptures. According to the prophet Samuel, the soul of Jonathan was knit with the soul of David, and Jonathan loved him as his own soul. Then Jonathan and David made a covenant because he loved him as his own soul. Samuel later writes that eventually the two parted ways and never saw each other again. Upon receipt of the news of Jonathan having been killed, David mourned deeply and said, "I am distressed for thee, my brother Jonathan. Very pleasant hast thou been unto me. Thy love to me was wonderful, passing the love of women." And then, probably better known to most, is the story of Ruth and Naomi. So inspiring because of the love of this one woman, Ruth, for her mother-in-law, Naomi. A somewhat unusual situation, even today. The immortal words, "Whither thou goest, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge," which Llandro is now going to sing to Martin, is the essence of the love of two people for each other.
I promise to love and sustain you.
give myself to you to be your spouse. And I promise to love and sustain you. Comfort and confide in you. To stand by you. In joy and in sorrow. In sickness and in health. In plenty and in want. All the days of my life. May I have His grace. A ring is a symbol that binds two people together and reminds you of the commitment that you are making to each other as well as to God. Would you please join me in prayer? Gracious God, with these rings remind Llandro and Mark of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in all of their life together they may know the joy and the peace that grows from love and from mutual respect. Amen. And would you place it on the speaker? Please repeat after me. Llandro, I give you this ring.
Llandro, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our love and faithfulness.
As a sign of our love and faithfulness.
Just as these grains of sand can never be separated into their individual containers again, so may you be as one. Most of all, dear God, give to Llandro and Martin the ability to laugh together to cry together, and to love each other more and more deeply with each and every passing year. Amen. Llandro and Mark, you have committed yourselves to each other in this joyous and sacred ceremony. Fulfill your promises, live in peace, and allow your love to grow day by day, and receive great joy and many blessings. And now, since you have united yourselves in faithful loving, I pronounce in the name of God that you are married one to the other. You may now seal your promises with a kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, with great pleasure,